All right, anyways, well, let's take a look at these plays here. So first up, CJ Buller and friends team play. This is going to be vote one for this one. Patty Prince said here, I know this guy, can't let him win. He was nay on it in round one. They are up 3-1 with a minute and a half left. This is going to be vote one for this one. Vote one for this one.
That was a nice play.
Guys, no joke, I just tried to push that guy's glasses up on my own face. I swear to God, I just was like looking at him and went like this and was like, wait a minute, I'm not wearing glasses. I swear to God, I just did that. I wish I had done it before I got out of the other scene. I was like, why does this feel weird? Why? Oh my God, I'm not wearing glasses. Anyways, yes. Stone cold reaction from him. Shit, usually you see people jump out of their chair. Yeah, he definitely stone facing that one. He's like gimmick and torment and squishy all in one. Yep. So that's vote one there for that one. Then we got vote two here for Night Panda's nice angle. This is going to be vote two for this one here. Vote two for it. Blue team down by three with 3.5 minutes left. Again, vote two.
Vision?
Oh,
oh my god,
Vision!
Wait.
No, that was Panda.
Oh, yeah. Oh my god, Panda. What the fuck?
Bro, that's a clip and a half.
Vision?
Oh,
oh
my god, Vision!
Wait.
No, that was Panda.
Oh, yeah. Oh my god, Panda. What the fuck?
Bro, that's a clip and a half.
Says vote two for that one. I forgot to read my comment, which is, I don't know why, but for some reason I like this. I don't know why, but for some reason I like that. It was vote two. We got vote three here. For Owen Ground Pinch, my comment on this one was, I haven't actually yayed anything yet, so sure. It was bleak for a long time. I was getting really worried. I think there were 40 clips left when I got to this one, and I still hadn't yayed anything. It's not that bad that I'm, like, making it out, though. I am a real person, lol. Seriously, right? So, yeah, anyways, this is vote three here for this one. Vote three for this one.
One. Yes. Yes. One. Yes.
Alright, it says vote 3 right there, and by the way, I don't know if any of you guys are bothered by this, but I can't figure out why Auto Duck isn't working, so sorry we have two competing musics going on. The thing that's supposed to mute my music when clips start playing is not working for some reason, and I can't figure out why. Anyways, what's up, Manhattan? How you doing? Look at the bottom left of your stream, look at how cute you are. Aw, thanks, Manhattan. It's a disappointment. Seems I basically saved you 30 seconds of life. Yeah, okay, so that was vote 3 right there. And then last up here, vote 4 for Squishy's Clutch, well-placed ceiling shot. I had a comment on this one that got lost because I had to change the clip out because whoever originally clipped this deleted it for some reason and I had to go re-clip it. I think my comment was something to the effect of like, I know, but like, it's still pretty nice and it's clutch. So this is vote four here for this one. Vote four for this one. Note the score line here, down by a goal with 4 seconds left. This is vote four for it. They have four goals and there's 4 seconds left and it's vote four. That's, you know, that's something. Anyways, vote four here. So that's vote four for that one there. What's up, Pant? How you doing? He teases that reset for a while. I kind of like it, even though Justa... Dude, it's a zero. Like I said, I think if it weren't squishy, that one would be in competition. That would be like one of the two we were talking about. But because it's squishy, it's not. But it's like 0 seconds, perfectly placed. And he like calls it ahead of time. He's like, dude, I got you. And then goes and like pops that shit in. I actually really like this one. But I feel like it's not really going to get much love just because it's squishy. And also Manhattan, by the way, I actually had pretty much completely forgotten that you used to be Erotic Nugget. Like Shustin said, sup Nugget, and Nipchok saying he'll always be our Erotic Nugget. I was like, what are they talking about? And I was like, and then I saw your dead naming is on the Laughing Matter joke. And that's when I was like, oh yeah, that's right. Manhattan was Erotic Nugget. Yeah, BJ saying it's a good night in my opinion. I feel like this is a slightly above average. Night. I mean, I feel like, first of all, to me, I thought number one was going to be the one people went for, and so far, you know, Arsenal's the only person who's voted, and it's for number two, although Niptrax just came in for number four. I thought we were going to be between one and four, but maybe it's two and four? I feel like three can definitely get out of here. Anyways, what's up, Pant? Actually, Torn is a good night, so I'm going to be hitting the nuttiest shot that was ever shot with new mechanics and insanely good team play. It'll be happening on 5th of July. Where can I submit it once I've recorded it? I feel like we're going to have a channel in the Discord just for, like, sharing clips. Just as, like, a way of, like, weaning us off of that practice. Just because, like, shit like that's going to happen. You guys are going to be like, oh my god, I have to share this. So we're just, like, going to have a Rocket League clips channel. And also for, like, you know... Once, like, Valencia is going to be right after I stop, and, like, we're not going to want it, it's going to be really awkward to be watching Valencia and just have, like, no clip sharing or discussion at all going on. So, yeah, I think I'm going to have to start a channel the Discord for, like, you know, clip sharing. Nipchuck saying, vote four, fuck it, it has everything we look for. BJ saying, two or three, I'm torn, really? Manhattan saying vote one, I only saw two and four, and I have to believe that one is better. Okay. Just like not pick a winner tonight. Nope. Gotta pick a winner. Okay. So BJ's between two and three. Manhattan's on one, Arsenal's on two, Niptrox is on four. You guys want me to just play him again? It seems like we have sort of, like, no idea what we want to vote for. I feel like playing him again might be the right move. So, here's one again.
That was a nice play.
So that's one, here's two.
Vision?
Oh my god, Vision! Wait,
No, that was Panda.
Oh, yeah. Oh my god, Panda. What the fuck?
Bro, that's a clip and a half.
So that's two. He never actually fixes his glasses. I know, that's why I was doing that. I know. Anyways, that's two. Here's three.
Yes!
Yes! Says three, and then the last one here is number four. Hold on, I gotta get him saying, I got you.
Alright, I got you.
You know, I gotta be honest, I'm thinking four. I'm with Carbon and Niptrox. I think four's got it. So we got Carbon and Niptrox on four. We got Manhattan and Arsenal on two. And then just Bears on one. Nobody on three. Manhattan saying three is so slow, it's just a ground pinch, right? Pants saying three is real nice shot, but it looks pretty savable. Vayron, because you're new here, you can't actually vote in this round. You kind of got screwed because we skipped straight to this round tonight. But I will keep in mind that your preferences for number four. Also, Pant asking in the new stream, are we all gonna be like that? We are all gonna be like that classic Chris Farley SNL sketch where he's fanboying out while he interviews all his guests. Hey, you remember the last time? Sorry. Hey, you remember the time Justin had that crazy goal in RLCS land? Remember? Yeah, maybe a little bit. BJ saying two or four now, in my opinion now. Okay. Shutson saying one is basic as fuck. Two is at least a cool shot. Three is sleeper plus no defense. Four is Justa. Four is not Justa. That's an incredibly unfair criticism of four. First of all, it's a 0 second goal. I mean, I realize Squishy doesn't really give a shit about this game, but it is still a 0 second goal. Second of all, he does a really nice job of reading the defense, holding his foot preset to like the exact right time, and then putting it perfectly in the top corner. Like, there are a lot of cool things going on there. It is not just a flip reset, or a ceiling shot, or whatever the fuck it was. Shutson saying four is the worst, it's so just it. It's really not. You see how he comes off the ceiling? Four is just so boring and basic, man. Again, if it weren't Squishy, this would so obviously be the winner. If it weren't Squishy, this would so obviously be the winner. But because it's Squishy, you guys are looking at a motherfucker who's literally just like perched on top of the backboard and going, well, shit, that's a really nice angle, and are picking that one. Like, Squishy's is Justa and this isn't? I'm sorry, what? This is the Justa play. This is just a nice angle. He is literally just sitting on the backboard and he hits the ball in the net. I have seen this play a goddamn 1,005 million times. This is the Justa. I mean, they're all pretty Justa, but two is Justa. Four is like got a lot of cool shit going for it, but it's Squishy, so y'all are just like, eh. I don't know, he's kind of just hitting a ceiling shot to the exact right spot at the last possible second to tie the game. Meh. We're between two and four, so what do I vote? Go four, BJ, but we're going to talk about two and four for a little bit in a second. I want to get one and three off the board first, though. It's just a flip reset, and that's my point, is it's not just a flip reset. There's a lot of other shit going on. It is not just a flip reset. I know it was 0 seconds, exactly. That's what a ceiling shot is? You have to wait? No, you don't have to wait. You don't have to wait quite that long. That's why Taroko committed and comes off the walls because he's like, well, shit, he's got to be going any second now. And Squishy's like, no, I waited an extra half fucking second and then, put it exactly behind you. I don't think this just is incredibly unfair. I think it's borderline, but I agree it's the best of the four we have. Vote four. I mean, yeah, I will agree it is somewhat Justa, but compared to the other three, you can't call this one Justa. That dude who shot four could honestly go pro. He has a good read on the game. Squishy shot is like a mirror of a shot from Alpha from RLCS. I believe that. Four is literally just a ceiling shot. What do you mean, Alec? No, it wouldn't. Not at all. Yeah, two sucks too, but it's cool. He doesn't jump, just hits it after a while. It's to tie the game at 0 seconds. He places it perfectly and reads the defense beautifully. Four is just a ceiling shot with a 360. You're telling me you haven't seen four 1,000 times? Not really. 0 second, perfectly placed, well defensively read ceiling shot? No, I haven't seen that as often as guy is above net, guy hits ball, ball goes into net. Like, this is just a nice angle. If anyone can give me anything other than the fact that he hits a nice angle here, I will accept that maybe four is just as this is. But given that this is just a nice angle, and then this is just a ceiling shot with three other cool things about it, maybe only two, I forget how many cool things there are, but the point is, this is just one thing, and this is multiple things, so this is the justa. Diamond Flipper says the ceiling shot. Yeah, he literally gets free play amount of space and Squishy places it nicely. Watch it again a few times. I beg of you, get your head straight. Also, I know it's Squishy, but it always makes it extra impressive for me just having such a who cares attitude about pulling something like that off. I got you, chillax. I know, right? That definitely makes it slightly cooler. But all right, let's get one and three out of here real quick first. So anyone still feeling like the team play is you know, the best play? I mean, it's kind of nice, but it really is just a three-point pass play, right? Or is it four? One, it's four, two, three, and then goal, yeah. What's this link here? Top dot corner. A little over-aggressive there, Twitch, turning that into a link. Bear is saying, nah, it's pretty slow. Nipchuck saying, well, I have my reason and vote, so I am leaving. All right, fair enough. What was your reason again, by the way? You are just a Shutson. Like, that's your reason. Fuck it, it has everything we look for. Fair enough. Can't do it for one only because he's literally looking down his nose at us viewers. What's up, Wacom? Fuck you, Wacom. Four for life. All right, and then three also. No one really feeling this ground pinch, right? We can get rid of this. See? See? Nightbot says yes. Nightbot says yes to number four. So yeah, if anyone really likes this one, drop a vote three very fast or I'm going to eliminate it. And then we can keep talking about two and four. Oh man, that defensive whiff really ruins this one. I hadn't quite appreciated that the first time around. Fuck did I do? So I'm guessing there's no vote threes here. I ain't do shit, dumb Manhattan. Voting for four, that was the dumb thing. Dude! Four is so much better than two! What the fuck? Two is such a shit shot! I mean, it's not, it's like really good. But like, you know, four is legitimately just a guy above the net, hitting the ball down into the net. It's like the most common goal that is ever scored. It's more common than like, you know, a power shot after a teammate centers it. Two would not have made it here on a normal right, four would have potentially, thus four wins. Okay. Shutson saying, what? That's not true. Legitimately, I expected you guys to like make fun of me for yaying this goal. I legitimately expected you guys to be like, you know, seriously, this thing? Really? And then just like all nay it and like make fun of me for yaying bad shit. I legitimately was expecting to get roasted for yaying this goal right here. And now you guys are all saying it's better than a 0 second top corner ceiling shot. Four makes me want to die. Wacom saying, lol, this is common. I have a tighter one. I don't doubt that for a second, Wacom. Carbon thinks I'm dumb for it. Thank you, Carbon. Thank you. That's what I'm saying. I think two is a clear worst of the bunch. Veyron agreeing. Shutson! It's not about the ceiling shot. How many fucking times do I have to say that, like, okay, yes, it's like ceiling, who gives a shit about ceiling shots? But who gives a shit about angles? And four is 0 seconds after calling a shot. He says, like, they're down by a goal. with 3 seconds left, he's like, alright, I got you. Takes the ball up to the ceiling, and then, like, you know, spins around just for funsies, sees Taroko over there, waits until it's too late for Taroko to defend the top corner, and then puts the ball motherfucking perfectly in the top corner. This is, like, the best ceiling shot that's ever been hit, is what we're looking at here, versus, like, a pretty cool tight angle goal. That is the conversation we're having right now. Best ceiling shot that's ever been hit versus, like, a, you know, like, nice tight angle. Honestly, this dude could have just shot upper corner. Yeah, that's fair. I watched Squishy do cooler things today. Well, they didn't get clipped, I guess. So it's just a zero here in ranked with no stakes. As opposed to... you know, they're down by 3, 2 minutes in. There's no stakes over here either. There is no stakes on any of them, but this one has, like, you know, a tiny little piece of stakes, little baby stakes. There's little baby stakes on this one. There's nothing on the other one. Spin kind of tells me all I need to know about Squishy's attitude to this play, to be honest. Okay, again, I don't care if, like, Squishy is super happy with it. I care if it's impressive. And it's clearly more impressive than the guy who's just like, fuck it, let me see if I can score from here. Oh shit, I did. Like, the other guy doesn't give a shit either. I wouldn't say the best ceiling shot. Now I know you're fucking with me. What is the best, like, when has there ever been a better ceiling shot than this? I mean, there were times where, like, ceiling shots were hit in more clutch situations. There were times when, like, you know, ceiling shots were newer and we got more excited about them. Like, you could say his ceiling shot from LAN, you know, season 4. But, like, that wasn't a better ceiling shot. It's just that, like, ceiling shots were cooler then. What's up, Strangest? Ceiling shot that's actually shot just above the floor is what makes it special for me. Wake on saying, I like 4, but I like 2. Carbon saying the second one has a game counter in the scoreboard, so it might be 6-man tournament. Yes, that is true. The second one is in a best of 5 series. I remember seeing that mutator pop up at the end here. Like, he pulls up the scoreboard towards the end, and you can see that it's got, like, best of 5 mutator. Series length 5 games. 2 is an accident, but I like 4. All right, Wakon, you know, kind of going back and forth. The squishy fake ceiling shot, the one from season 4 land. Yeah, that's not better than this. It's just that, like, ceiling shots were, like, really, that was the first ceiling shot in RLCS. That's why we remember that as, you know, the best ceiling shot. But it, like, isn't better than this. It was just, like, more impressive at the time. Can we submit Fireburner's retirement tweet? Because that's more important contextually than either of these plays. Yeah. Yeah. That one, that just makes me sad, though. Chaussette's mechanically perfect one, like, a month ago. I don't remember that. We'll say it's a rank B series, to be honest. Okay, I could see that. I mean, it's called Scrims, More Scrims, and then Games is the I'm guessing that's the stream title. So I would guess it's Scrims, actually, and not rank B. What is this Chaussette ceiling shot y'all are talking about?
Going off the ceiling.
Oh.
Ceiling shot just set! What a play coming in right away. And he boosts all the way up to the ceiling. That's how fast he was able to get to the ball. He boosted to the ceiling and managed.
How is that better? That's not better at all. Squishies is so, I mean, I'll give, again, if we were picking which one I'd vote for, I'd go for the one in RLCS. But, like, you know, purely just on the merits of, like, the actual shot, this is absolutely perfect. It could not be any better. Like, yes, I'm not gonna, if someone asks me what's the best ceiling shot that's ever been hit, I'm not gonna answer this one right here. Obviously not. I'm just saying, like, you know, if you strip all context out of anything, and which I think is fair given this one, as terrible as its context is still better context than scrims in the random middle of a scrim. So this one does win on context, and if you put context aside, this is like the best ceiling shot that's ever been hit. Not gonna lie, two is looking pretty clean though. Leave. Don't leave, Veyron. It's a pretty decent pass to the dude, and that's not exactly an easy shot. Neither is that. And no, it's not easy, but you know. It's not even like placed well. I like Fort better, I'm just saying two isn't completely garbage. No, two is not completely garbage. It is absolutely not. It's a really nice shot. It's just like, you know, takes two bounces to go in. And he's just like, you know, sitting on top of the fucking net. You know, going like that. Four is a pretty generic ceiling shot, dude. The only thing that makes it kind of good is the second bird. Am I taking fucking crazy pills? Are you guys not seeing that he like reads the defense, waits till he can't save it, and then puts it right behind him in this like ball-sized hole that is between Taroko and the top corner of the net? Like, it is not just that it's at 0 seconds. It's also that he's, like, reading the defender and then places the ceiling shot perfectly behind him. Like, can you guys just all admit that the only reason you don't think this is better is because it's squishy? Can we just, like put our cards on the table and say you guys like two because it's not squishy and you don't like four because it is squishy? Because that is the only reasonable argument I can see that, like, this is just a ceiling shot here. Again, I'm not saying it's, like, mind-blowingly amazing. I'm just saying that it's better than the guy who hits the ball in from above the net, which I swear to God happens 90,000 times a day. I feel like this is an April Fool's stream. Can you play again? This one or two? This one? I'm gonna try real hard to imagine it's not squishy. All right, go for it, Shutson. BJ saying not 0 seconds. I would vote for the other one, definitely. Okay, I think that might be fair. I might agree with that. But the 0 seconds, I think, does, even though it's, like, squishy and he doesn't care about winning this ranked game, like, the 0 second part of it does add something to this, you know? Like, everyone, you still care a little bit about, like, you know, a ranked game. Stand four. All right. Wait, Shutson saying, yeah, I hate it still. Saying, so anything special planned for the final RL stream? Maybe we do all menu screen and camera settings clips, camera shake clips only. Yeah, I don't know. Someone suggested doing like top 10 dailies winners of all time thing. I don't want to do a send-off for a couple reasons. Number one, I hate pomp and circumstance and sentiment and all those sorts of things. And the idea of doing a special stream for the last stream makes me feel physically ill. And then number two, like that seems like a lot of fucking work. Doing like a top 10, you know, dailies winners of all time. And then I have to like tweet those plays and I don't care. I just want to like be done. And then number three, I don't want it to be like a big, you know, end of the dailies event. Given that I've really been trying to work on not saying like it's the end of the dailies and not making it seem that way, because it is not. Like, we're gonna keep going. We're just not talking about Rocket League anymore. So I really don't want people to have this feeling of like, oh, that was a great send-off for the dailies. What a nice end to that sort of story. Like, I don't want that. I want people to be like, okay, well, the dailies is off for a little while, and when they come back, they're gonna be doing some new weird thing that sounds kind of dumb, but whatever. You know, so I hate pomp and circumstance and sentiment. I don't want to do all that work, and I don't want to do a big end of the dailies thing, because it's not the end of the dailies, it's just, you know, a hiatus for a little while. I won't say that it's mind-blowing or amazing. Also, this is the best ceiling shot that's ever been scored. Yeah, the best ceiling shot that's ever been scored isn't going to be mind-blowingly amazing. I mean, like, I'm not gonna, like, act like I could actually defend this is the best ceiling shot ever scored. I'm sure if you actually wanted to, you could go back through, like, our archives and find five better ceiling shots. I'm just saying this is a, like, ridiculously perfect ceiling shot. As Niptrox said before he left, it has everything we look for. No, Wakon. Debate is nice, that's fun. Yeah, definitely. Democratic primary debate. If we could get a super fan to bring us all the classic clipped Alec moments from this stream, I could get down with that. Yeah, I mean, I would find that super awkward and narcissistic to host, but it would probably be fun. And this is the good primary debate too. Yesterday was the undercard. today we got Bernie and Biden up there. Alright, so am I gonna have to do a junior prize for you fuckers? Super awkward and narcissistic? Sounds like the dailies. That is my Tinder bio, Carbon. Sounds not as fun as reading stream. Yeah, I've just streamed like 12 days in a row at this point, I think. And I'm sick of you guys, and I didn't want to be done and have it be the weekend. I feel doing any sort of champion of champions is pointless as fuck. Yeah, I kind of feel that way too. It would just be such an intense process to go through, and like at the end of the day, we'd all just be like, I don't know, man. Like, this is season 4 LAN, but this is season 6 LAN, which is higher stakes? And it would just be like, I don't know. I don't think it would actually be that interesting. Justin, and that's the other thing. Justin wins. Squishy comes second. Devo comes third. Yeah, I feel like we actually, you know, pretty much know. Bernie and Biden, that sounds like a shit show. Yeah, and then like 8 other people. I mean, it's not going to be an actual debate. It's just like 10 people standing on stage doing a Q&A, doing simultaneous Q&As. So there's not going to be any. There will be like one moment of back and forth. I think in like last night's debate, there were like 20 times someone interrupted someone else, which sounds like a lot, but it was like, you know, hundreds of questions. And most of the interruptions were just like, excuse me, Quinn, what do you think about the fact that Americans are dying? And then someone else was like, I don't fucking care. Fuck Americans. Boo. Fuck all of you. And then like pissed all over the audience. But yeah, the point is, it's not a debate. It's just a simultaneous Q&A. Justin, we should do a top 10 Alec moments and pick a winner. I choose that time Alec really screamed at us like a month ago. Okay, I'm sick of you too. Take that. Nice. I'm glad. I'm not surprised, Wakon. I'm sick of me. I would never be sick of you, strangest. You weren't here all weekend, so I'm not sick of you. But most of these fuckers I've been talking to literally for like 12 days straight. We spent all weekend hanging out with them. Last weekend. On 0 seconds, not to rush. That shot is great. Thank you. Thank you, VJ. Maybe you should have bought a mic. Oh yeah, that was the time I really screamed at you guys. I was trying to remember what that was. Man, I said vote for whatever, just fucking end it. I love this last week of class feel we've got going on here. Where I'm just like, I just don't want to be streaming right now. And you guys are like, yeah, I don't want to be in class right now. It's like, alright, fuck it, vote for, let's go home. Maybe that RV goal on Sunday would sneak in top 5. It would, just because of recency bias, I think. I think, like, in 2 years, if we looked at, like, the top goals up until now, it might not make top 5. It might not. I'm not saying it definitely wouldn't, but it might not. But if we did it right now, it definitely would. Kind of excited to see Yang. Yang's a fucking huckster. I don't give a shit about Yang. I mean, like, you know... First of all, I think he's giving UBI a bad name. I think he's presenting UBI as, like, you know, neat bucks, when it is, you know, really supposed to be a very different concept from that. From, you know, if you listen to anyone who's, like, a serious UBI proponent, which I'm not, like, prepared to give you guys that spiel right now, and I don't feel like it. But if you go look at, like, actual UBI proponents, they all hate Andrew Yang. Like, you'd expect them to be like, hey, he's, like, getting mainstream, he's mainstreaming this idea of UBI. And they're all like, no, he's totally fucking up our shit and making it seem like UBI is just, like, you know, straight up government handouts and not, like, an actually efficient way of administering aid if it were, you know, done in just, like, a couple specific ways. Thank you so much for that question about how to fight terrorism. We need an economy that works for all Americans. Thank you. Applause, please. Yeah, right. Exactly, Pant. I'm excited to watch Biden put his foot in his mouth. Yeah. I am actually really looking forward to the just, like, upcoming, like, just destruction of Biden's reputation. Like, in my mind, there is 0% chance he gets the nomination. And we just get to watch this, like, guy go from, like, Uncle Joe to just, like, an old racist, like, you know, geriatric that no one likes, and like in front of the whole country. I just feel like it's gonna be really fun to just watch everyone go from like thinking of him as like fun Uncle Joe, just being like, oh, you're like actually like old school racist. Okay, yeah, that's fine, man. Just get out of politics, please, and go die quietly. And you know, like, the man could have just retired and just like, you know, lived a beautiful life as like everyone's favorite guy, and he could come out every once in a while and be like, oh, I'd like to punch Trump in the face. And we'd all be like, ah, silly Uncle Joe. But motherfucker just had to get in the race and fucking wreck his reputation. And I personally am very excited to watch it happen. Yawn. Excited to watch DreamHack, yep. When is last show? July 3rd. DreamHack is next weekend, yep. I don't like Yang particularly because he's sort of Milton Friedman incarnate, but I feel like he's at least a semi-principled thinker dude. I kind of refuse to believe that anyone like that Silicon Valley has like principles. You know, I think his principles are like the absence of principles, basically. Like, you know, he's basically I don't actually know that much about him. I just get really shitty vibes from him. And I know that people I like think he's fucking up the UBI discussion. His reputation? How can the pervert's reputation get any worse? Wait, wrong person, shit. No, that's Biden. I mean, Biden's a pervert also, but that's exactly my point, is like, 6 months ago, you know, if Biden weren't gonna be running for president, no one would be calling him a pervert. But now he's running for president, so we got all these videos out of him, like, you know, rubbing little girls' shoulders and shit. And we're just like, oh, this is a creepy old man who's, like, you know, got boundary issues and was friends with segregationists and you know, spent his career pushing, like, racist policy and standing up for credit card companies and bullshit business stuff. That we were done with Biden in, like, 2016. Yeah, we were supposed to be. Why don't old people just retire? Exactly, that's my point. Yang, the semi-principled thinker, dude. That should be his campaign slogan right there. You don't think Biden has been around long enough to dilute the dirt on him? I think that's an advantage for him having been in the public eye for so long. I could be wrong. Obviously that is true. Like, the fact that he is still the front runner means that you are correct. What I'm just saying, though, is that, like, he's just going to keep appearing in public and saying things that are wildly out of touch and, like, offensive to various groups and, like, not actually appealing to anybody. And he's, like, all of his appeal right now is people who just, like, want to go back to normal. They want to go back to the way things were when Obama was president, and they think that Joe Biden can do that because they're dumb. And they think they're not, like, smart thinker people or whatever the fuck that phrase was. They're just dumb people who think, remember that everyone wasn't as mad in 2014 as they are now. So clearly Obama's presidency was good and Trump's is bad. So we should go back to Obama, and Biden is basically that. And that's, like, the whole entirety of his appeal. And they, like, you're right. He's been in the public eye for so long, so he's got a lot of name recognition, a lot of, you know, The Onion made him into this, like, lovable character. And so he's got all of that. And then, like, as people actually engage with him and, like, watch him speak, they're gonna be like, wait a minute, this is my old racist grandfather. I don't like this guy. I mean, he's, like, cute and whatever, but I don't want him to be president. And because he's running, everyone's gonna, like, start attacking him and doing all kinds of, you know, oppo and shit, and he's gonna have his reputation destroyed. I did mean Biden, yeah. Is there a show for DreamHack? No, there's not gonna be. There are zero redeeming qualities about Joe Biden in my head, man. Yeah, I mean, there's, like, one or two. There are some redeeming qualities. Like, he seems like a very personable guy. He seems very friendly. He's got a nice deep voice for a while there. I'm not gonna tell you guys that story. But yeah, he's a decent man. He's just old. I mean, for a whatever year old man he is, he's, like, not that racist. You know, he's not that sexist. He's not that out of touch. But, like, for 2020, he's fucking massively racist and out of touch. How can anybody, a Democrat, be pro-Biden? I don't get it. I mean, again, it's what I just said. They want to go back to before everyone was yelling all the time. You know, back to when politics were nice and friendly in the Obama era, because they thought they weren't paying attention, you know, they just knew that, like, people weren't having rallies and shit all the time. It's, a very common mindset that, like, everything was great until Donald Trump came out of nowhere. I mean, that is Joe Biden's pitch. That was his campaign announcement speech, was, like, everything was great, and then Donald Trump fucked it up. And so I'm gonna punch Donald Trump in the jaw, and Republicans will have an epiphany, and nothing will fundamentally change, and we'll go back to everyone just, you know, getting along with the you know, and it'll be great. And that's Joe Biden's pitch, and a lot of people think that's true, and none of them realize that, like, everything about Trump is a function of decisions that were made during the Obama presidency, and that, like, you know, not just a function of things, but, like, this rising thing that, like, you know, the Democrats have totally failed to deal with or provide any kind of counter messaging to, this rise of, like, authoritarian fascism that has taken over the Republican Party and makes up a significant chunk of, like, its base, like, this rising authoritarian racist whatever thing, like, they were just like, oh, blah, 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 the Republican Party won't be a thing in 8 years anyways. Like, we don't have to worry about them. We're just gonna keep, like, sucking corporate dick and bailing out Wall Street and foreclosing illegally on all kinds of people's homes and not prosecuting any bankers. And I'll go to Flint and drink the water and then not do anything, you know, and just totally betray the promise of being the first black president. Sorry, I just got lost. I lost myself a little bit there in shitting on Obama. But the point is, like, everyone has this attitude that, like, Trump came out of nowhere and ruined America. And that if we just, you know, get a nice guy like Joe Biden back in charge, everything will go back to being okay. It's like, nah. No. The cat is out of the bag. We are in this shit right here. We need to actually fucking deal with it. Obama equals normal. Oh, right, that's the question I was answering. But Alex, yeah.
What the hell are you? I'm Batman.
What's up, Bat? How you doing, man? What sucks about that thought process is that people are still mad over Obama, but the people mad about Trump are so loud and so in your face about it that it makes everyone think more people are mad. Well, the issue is that the people who were mad about Obama were very, like, cloistered off. Like, the conservative wing of media has done a really great job of creating this, like, really tight ecosystem that they live in and can kind of just, like, you know, like, it's a very intense echo chamber, basically. And so, like, Fox News comes out and says, like, Obama wants to kill your grandmother because she's white, and everyone's like, rah, rah, and they get all mad about that shit, and it's this whole thing, but it doesn't, like, bleed out into the mainstream. Because, you know, like, everyone in the mainstream just looks at it and goes, like, no, he doesn't. That's not a story. Maybe they'll report on the fact that Fox News said that, but it just has this thing of, like, ah, kooky Fox News over there in their dead party telling, you know, lies, propaganda to their you know, their base. But then now, you know, like, Trump and every, it's like a much more mainstream thing because there's no, like, tight-knit, you know, liberal media world. And so it just sort of, like, is no everywhere. And also, Trump is sort of, you know, Trump is kind of reprehensible to a much broader group of people than Obama was, so it's a much bigger story. Also, just, you know, there's the John Mulaney horse in a hospital concept that just, like, you can't take your eyes off of Trump, you know? He's this media spectacle, whether you love him, hate him, or, you know, wish he would just go away, like, you can't take your eyes off of him. So that's my read on that. Being at war is normal for us, so Obama is the way, yep. I agree. Now, under the spotlight, there will be a whole lot of digging to find the worst aspects of Biden. However, if not Biden, who do you think ends up with the nom? It's going to be Elizabeth Warren. I've been saying that for a long time. I think she's going to be the nominee. You came in just as we became a trading channel. What's up, Vale? We're pretty much done, to be honest with you. But yeah, you actually figured it out, so nice. Americans be over here moaning that a presidential candidate could possibly be a racist sexist. No, I'm not moaning. First of all, like, our guy's worse than your guy. Pretty sure. Pretty sure Trump beats Boris in terms of racist sexistness. But I'm not like moaning about it. They've all, up until like Obama, they were all racist and sexist. And we had like one. Actually, to be honest, I don't think George W. Bush was racist or sexist. I actually don't think he was. I think he was just sort of like, you know, like principleless, like power fiend who just, you know, let people bully him up into power and you know, I don't actually, I think he was actually like a, you know, he did horrible, terrible things, he's a war criminal, yada, 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 but like, if you just like were sitting around talking with Bush, I think you would like think of him as like a pretty decent dude. Like, I honestly don't think he was racist or sexist, but Clinton definitely was, both, and every president before him, maybe not Jimmy Carter, maybe not FDR, but probably FDR. And then all the rest of them, yeah, definitely racist and sexist. Like, I'm, you know. Alright, Crazy Chipmunk. Someone want to time out Crazy Chipmunk? Thank you. If a Dem beats Trump, which I kind of doubt, given the ginormous Dem candidate crowd, we will see outrage culture shift to the right-wing folks in a quick way. Yeah, definitely. Of course, like, why would you be outraged if your guy's in charge? You get outraged because your guy isn't in charge. Vale has rep, so he can vote. We need a politics daily stream one day. What a great idea, Carbon. You know what? I'm going to start thinking about that. I think that's actually something we should maybe try to do. Back going two, huh? Fuck, I should have banged the gavel when I had the chance. See? Because it's squishy. Because it's squishy. That's the only reason you guys don't like it, is because it's squishy. Thank you, Bat, for fucking confirming that shit. They're tied in embarrassing hair. That's definitely true. My intro sounds like a bit to kick in. Yeah, I think there is a little bit of a delay. Saying people are moaning about Biden being racist despite the current president. Oh, that's what you're saying. Okay. Dude, no one cares. Americans want to elect racists. Yeah, but the Democratic primary voters don't want, like, they're big, like, the Democratic primary voters' biggest problem with the world right now is that America has a racist, sexist president. They don't, you know, like, they don't care about any of the, like, other shit. Their whole thing is, like, this isn't what we stand for. We're a nation of immigrants, like, rah, 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 rah. Like, that is what the Democratic primary voters care about. I agree that, like, being a racist and a sexist would not hurt Joe Biden in a general election. I think he's got a whole bunch of other negatives that would, and Trump can totally just run the same playbook that he ran against Hillary. You know, you're a member of the establishment. I'm, you know, the outsider. Even though I'm the president, now I'm the outsider trying to mess things up. You did this, and this, and this terrible thing that you, like, put your name on proudly, that everyone hates now. And, like, legitimately, you know, Trump, like, as much as Joe Biden could be like, oh, Trump, you've done this bad thing, Trump's like, you know, only been around for a few years. He hasn't had time to accumulate the record of terribleness that Joe Biden has. Was Clinton racist? Dude, do you not remember Ricky Ray Rector, I think is? No, that's not his name. What's up, Jim, by the way? No. Willie Horton. That's his name. Willie Horton. Bill Clinton pulled this big campaign stunt before he, when he was running for president, where he, like, literally flew home to Arkansas to, like, oversee the execution of a mentally challenged black guy that was, like, becoming this whole thing. Yeah, I don't remember the whole story here, but then also Bill Clinton, like, you know, kind of took credit for the whole crime bill that basically was one of the driving factors of the mass incarceration. And also he's, like, from Arkansas. Or actually, is he from Arkansas? I know Hillary isn't, but Bill is, right? Bill is definitely from Arkansas, yeah. But yeah, he's, you know, was born in Arkansas in 1946. By today's standards, I don't care if he's, like, done a lot of soul searching to try to not be racist. I'm sure he's racist. And then also, you know, he's, you know, pulled some racially tinged political stunts and is, you know, has his name on one of the more racist policies of the modern era. We don't elect our president, Judson. FDR wasn't racist or sexist, right? He had quite a few high-ranking female and black ones. Yeah, I mean, I feel like FDR, like, just because it was, like, the 40s, probably, like, was racist. Like, I guarantee you he thought, like, the Chinese were, like, a race of, like, you know, like, Stastral or something. I'm not up on my Chinese racism. But I bet you he, like, you know, was really hated the Chinese and shit, what was I gonna say? Like, probably, you know, was, like, pretty racist, but he just recognized that there were, like, a few good black people and felt like we were mistreating them, so he, like, you know, was a soldier. Like, I'm sure he was pro-black by the standards of his time, but I'm also pretty confident that, like, you know, if you dig through all of the like, published works and speeches of FDR, you would find some shit that could get him canceled these days. But that is pure speculation. I don't have anything to back that up. Politics dailies will never work. Guess it will, strangest. Fuck your gavel, bang dicks instead. What's up, Jim? No one even likes politics. If it wasn't Squishy, I'd have made that shit in round one. I really don't think so, Shutson. Like I say, not all individual Americans, but the American population wants to elect racists. Yeah. I think the DNC needs a board of directors or some way to limit how many clowns can come in competing for most woke. The way it sits now, I don't see how they can win. I don't know why you keep saying this, Pant. You said this before, too. Why does the fact that there are 24 candidates, like, hurt their chances in a general election? I don't see how that is, how one thing has anything to do with the other. Cory Booker's whole campaign is, look at me, I'm talking about women, blacks, and gay people. Don't you guys like that? Look at it, yeah. Stream not quick enough. What's up, Dusty? Yeah, I know. It ended up not being quick at all because we had to have an actual argument between these two plays, and now we're just talking about some random other shit. Oh, that's okay. You're talking about Mr. I didn't know what those things were, actually. I say it because I think the debates just become a circus of people trying to differentiate more than anyone else. I think it homogenizes the whole group and ultimately weakens it. I mean, first of all, there's a long history of, like, people being kind of radical in primaries and then moving to the center in the general. Like, that is like, what everyone expects people to do. So, I don't, like, people aren't really held to the policies that they had in the primaries, you know? And then also, like, you're saying they're all trying to differentiate, but then that homogenizes them? I don't follow that logic, that, like, trying to be different from everyone else ends up making them the same as everyone else. And I also think, like, you know, it's not gonna be Julian, like, the Julian Castro doesn't matter, you know? Like, no one gives a shit what Julian Castro's doing. Like, we have a three-way race right now between Biden, Warren, and Sanders, and then, like, maybe Kamala Harris is, like, you know, kind of nipping at the outside of it. Maybe some of the other ones, I haven't been paying too much attention to polling, but it's basically, like, if you look at the way the, like, narrative is going, it's basically a race between Biden, Warren, and Sanders, and then there's just all these other guys, like, you know, clowning around out there. And I mean, you know, to sort of back up my argument with, like, historical evidence, the Republicans had a whole bunch of candidates in the 2016 primaries, and, you know, they ended up doing kind of okay. I think having a lot of candidates is definitely harmful, unless the opposing party's frontrunner is hated like crazy, which is the case. But yeah, I think people would be stubborn and not vote at all if their candidate doesn't get in. I don't know why you think that. I will be. I pretty much would only vote for Bernie Sanders against Trump. I might. Elizabeth Warren, I'm open to. She could win me over. But other than that, I mean, I would vote for Trump over Biden. And other than that, I would probably just stay home. There are probably people who, like, have certain preferences, and if the candidate doesn't fit those preferences, then they won't vote. But that's not because of the primary process. Like, it's not because there are 24 candidates that, like, I'm gonna be like, oh, well, my guy didn't get in, so I'm not voting. It's just because I have a pretty strong set of beliefs and there's only one candidate who represents them and one who is pretending she does for a little while. Is he getting a junior? I guess. I mean, Manhattan only left because he wanted the stream to be over. And, I mean, it is kind of nice, and clearly Shuts in Manhattan and Bat think it's way better than number four. I think you guys are just being super biased because it's Squishy, but let me bang this thing. Let's do junior for two, full for four, so meeting adjourned, guys.